Gentlemen, I am joined here by Kiwi Kid. We're keeping the tradition going strong here. A little intimate interview at the end of the game once they get a victory. Kiwi Kid, there has been a change here for Dignitas. You guys have now gotten half of the amount of wins you guys had at the end of the spring split. What has changed that you can tell us about?
Definitely one of the biggest things. I'm finally like a decent player. I think we had a lot of problems with my play. But I fixed a lot, and also like I've been taking over a lot of like the mid to late game shot calling, and a lot of it I attribute to like our coaches Rico and Joyluck. They've helped a lot, and they've really put me on a path where I can not only can look for them for guidance, but I can watch VODs and like understand myself. Like I've been given fish and been taught how to fish, so I'm really thankful for them.
Best of both worlds coming out of that. The synergy as well with the Zingy coming out of the jungle, it just seems like there's a lot more for the team. You guys are a lot more, you know, just going in with his ultimates and assured that he will do the right thing. Where did that come from?
I've been actually talking to Zingy a lot, and I've been like, just as Rico and Joylug opened their arms to me, I've been opening my arms to Zingy, and I told him, like, just be confident. It's okay to make bad plays. I'd rather you'd make bad plays and talk than not playing anything at all. And just everything's been going really well, and I'm trying to help him out with this. Actually, I don't want to say because it's kind of one of our weaknesses, but if you've been watching, you can understand bans and picks, but no, I think we can go really far with this comp.
Very much so, and that's going to be difficult next week. Team solo mid and Gravity, how are you feeling about those matches? Final question.
I'm feeling pretty good. Like I feel finally like we can truly and slowly take them on, and yeah, I think they should be scared, so...
All right, Kiwi Kid, always a pleasure. Congrats on the win, man. We're going to throw it to the analyst desk to break down the rest of the day.
Thank you, Riv. I mean, Dignitas 3-1, it's been said. I don't think anyone would have expected them to be right up there tied for the number one slot this early into the season. So, you know, in trying to break down the things that have changed, one of the big things I think is Zingy and his confidence going into these games.
Yeah, we're talking about what Kobe was saying on the desk. When is somebody going to ban Zach against Zingy? Because he looks like a completely different player and an absolute monster on that champion. And this is the first time that Dignitas has had 3 wins in a row since summer last year, week one. So it's exactly a year since they last had it.
Woo! I mean, honestly, a lot of it has to do with the Zingy being a different player because he was easily the weak point of Team Dignitas down the stretch last year. And his Zac is very scary.
Yeah.
I think it's going to get banned away by TSM and Gravity next week, most likely, because you need to force him to have success on other champions. But all 3 of their wins have been a Zingy burning summoners, getting kills, getting people fed, and initiating teamfights in really powerful ways throughout all 3 matches.
Yeah, so I think that's where what Kiwi was talking about in their support staff, what their coaches have allowed them to do is going to really come into play to see what kind of adjustments they can make when those comfort champions are banned out and they're forced to pivot.
Yeah, and we saw that kind of happen last split when they had the Annie coming through for Kiwi Kid, and it's like, when are people going to ban Annie? And he's like, well, I hope people ban Annie, so I play something else. Maybe that's what's going to happen with the Zingy here. I don't know what else he has up his sleeve, but the Zac just far and away looks like his best champion. But if they do have more flexibility, that's something you need continuing on in the season, because are they going to keep continually picking up these wins just with this composition? Then they aren't going to grow as a team.
Yeah, I do want to touch quickly on Team 8 as well, because that's actually a team that is taking steps in the opposite direction to what they would have liked. You know, that's a team that was a 500 team for the majority of the split. I think at one point they were 7-7, and now they've opened up at 0-4, especially since this is the last split that we know of for Cali Trolls in the LCS. It's a tough road they have to go on now if they want to make a run for Worlds.
Right, and you've looked at games and knowing how they played in the spring split already, there are a few that we would have said this is a game that they should win. They should come in and take control. Now, how quickly Nien can kind of assimilate into the roster, we'll find out, because I think that will be a big linchpin when it comes to their success.
It's got to go fast.
Yeah, and that's the thing, though. It has to go fast because these splits are not as long as they seem, right? We're already we're through week 2. Like, separation is already beginning. 3-1 to 0-4. That's a lot of games you have to make up now at this point to move into the top tier of the bracket. You know, final thing to touch on, I'm going back over to Dignitas here, which is that their matchups next week, TSM and Gravity. I think this is where we're really going to get a sense of how good this team is, how much they have improved from last split.
yeah, those are now games to watch, right? Because previously you're thinking, oh, TSM versus Team Dignitas, if it's last split, 90% fan vote or something. But this one could actually be legitimately close, depending on the pick and ban phase and depending on what momentum Team Dignitas can bring through.
Right, Gravity, another one of those teams that we were saying is much improved from last split. Well, let's check out how the standings have changed after our 10 games this week. We've got half of the league tied for first place with 3 wins. Then one game back, it's Enemy Esports and TIP in 6th. It's Gray Skies for Cloud9, though, who slide into 8th, followed by Teammate and TDK in 9th. But from a packed field, here are the top 5 players for their positions. Starting in the top lane, we have Hanser.
Yeah, he was the only guy who gave Ryze a loss in the NALCS, and he had no help doing that. He was sitting up there, top lane Maokai, and he's like, all right, I'm not going to die to this. Then he plays Ryze himself, he gets resources, and shows that if you do put resources into him, he can take over a game.
Well, now here's a big one. We move into the jungle, and we find Move.
Yeah, this guy came out of nowhere, because last week everyone was thinking how bad the new Gravity Jungle Edition looked, and then this week he comes out, total vision control, amazing early games. Also, his ability to defer kills to his solo laners and the patience he had, everything was incredibly impressive this week about Move.
Absolutely instrumental in their wins. This week's man in the mid lane won't come as much of a surprise. It's Bjergsen. He had 2 explosive games on LeBlanc to help pull TSM into a share of first place and taking down their rival CLG in the process. Then we move into the AD carry slot and we find Altec.
Yeah, Altec had an amazing game yesterday on Sivir, just facilitating his team and picking up a lot of kills. And then today, once again, another game of Sivir, just being a big force in that bottom lane, and he's a big part of that combination now and the confidence that Gravity has found.
A farm machine, to say the least. Finally, our standout support is Lustboy.
Bart. But honestly, Lustboy did more than just play Bart. It was key in their victory against COG. The leadership that he shows through vision control and starting fights for TSM in a lot of ways shines through, and he was by far the best support this week.
I was going to say, his willingness to make plays, or at least take a stab at making plays, is huge. But the top honor this week is going to Gravity's Move. He has been doing a lot for Gravity, getting his team early leads, controlling vision on the map, and Gravity's 2-0 results this week speak for themselves.
Yeah, it was crazy to think Gravity, especially with the schedule they had coming in here, playing against Cloud9 as well as Team Liquid, who was a 3-0 team, especially after the performance Move had in week 1, to put up those kind of numbers on a new team, second week in the NALCS stage, impressive.
Yeah, and Move, I feel like even though he's the rookie in the NALCS, there's a lot for veterans to learn from him. Vision control, selflessness in the jungler, to give your side lanes, to give your solo lanes the kills, and the patience to be aggressive in a lane and allow, like we saw that clip there where he's just sitting there waiting for Rek'Sai for the counter gank. Really good presence, and the fact that he's killing the most wards out of junglers and he's placing the most wards out of junglers while still having that pressure is huge.
And pulling out the Jarvan in a meta that doesn't necessarily support that pick is nice to see. Now, our league action returns on Tuesday and Wednesday with the European and North American Challenger Series qualifier finals to determine which teams will compete in the Challenger Series. Also hitting your browser on Wednesday is a piping hot, fresh out of the oven new edition of Primetime League. Then on Thursday, the European LCS is going to kick off in Berlin with the new powerhouse Origin taking on the Unicorns of Love, followed by Rawcat versus Giants Gaming. Then on Saturday, the action returns to LA, beginning with Enemy Esports facing off against Teammate. And after that, it's Team Solomid battling Team Dignitas. That's set to hit your browsers at noon Pacific, 9 p.m. Central European summertime. And in case you missed it, earlier this week, we announced the locations for our upcoming European and North American Summer Split Finals. On August 22nd and 23rd, the LCS goes on the road with our European counterparts heading to Stockholm, Sweden. And for the North American Finals, we're headed to the Big Apple and we'll be setting up in the historic Madison Square Garden. Check back on lulesports.com for all the information on how you can pick up tickets later this month. Well, that does it for week 2. Now for myself and the entire live broadcast team, thank you for watching and we'll see you next week.
Let's get down to business right now with our first match, Cloud9 versus Team Impulse. Good hit the full team here. A nice hit back by the Emperor's Divide. Impact and Rush in a bad spot here. Incarnation takes a few shots. Sneaky, one last hit. The Distortion back actually takes balls into a bad spot.
Yeah, bottom, done. GG.
Team Impulse take down Cloud9. Take split, very close to take it on. Hanzo pushes him up against the wall. There's the Seraph's Embrace along with the RK Mastery coming out.
Oh, keep
that shield on. Piglet has to run for his life. The Desperate Power's on. He locks him up. He comes up with a double kill. Gravity takedown, Team Liquid to go 3-1. The crowd is more than ready, representing the Goliath versus Goliath match here.
I'm on double.
Team Solo mid takedown counter Logic Gaming.
Yeah, Coach, you're playing now.
Oh, already?
Yeah, new mid.
Coach, try them yet. So good.
Oh, no. He plays Varus now.
I'm new coach. Shut up.
Smoothie getting caught out right there. Kaz also going to get rooted up by Inox, and that's going to be a two-man Bard. He'll do cards this fight out. Bard is victorious for the second game in a row. Enemy improved to 2-2. 5-4, in comes the engage. Dodo tanks up what he can. Slushy getting knocked into the inhibitor, betrayed by his own base. Team Dignitas, they end week 2 tied for second place.